Dear students, in this lecture, we will be continuing with the organoborane in organic synthesis. In previous lectures, we have studied about the different properties of boron, as well as its reactions with alkenes that we have seen it, simple reactions where different organoboranes can be generated. In the last lecture, we had seen about the isomerization, regioselectivity, and stereoselectivity of the organoboranes. Now, in this lecture, we will be continuing with this, with the different types of reactions of these organoboranes. First, we will see about the alkenes, and then different other reactions we will be looking into in this particular lecture. We will see the reactions of organoborane compounds, organoboranes from alkenes. First is oxidation of alcohols, oxidation to alcohols. So alcohols can be easily formed when we have this R3B. From BH3 or B2H6, we have formed this organoborane. Now we are reacting it with H2O2 in presence of NaOH. In catalytic amount, it will be giving us 3ROH plus NaH2BO. Boric acid, sodium borate, and water molecule will be generated. So here we can get this alcohols very easily. The reaction can proceed if this is reacting with H2O2. H2O2 will be attacking the empty orbital of this boron and will form a peroxide. So from here, this group can be transferred over here and OH can be released out. So R is transferred from boron to oxygen in presence of OH minus ion. So we will get R. Here we will have Br. Now further, it can be easily cleaved to form ROH. So such things we can easily form it by using H2O. We can easily form this ROH from here. Examples for this can be if we have a cyclohexene, 1-methyl cyclohexene, if we react with B2H6. And followed by H2O2 in NaOH. Prepared organoborane compounds, and then we are now doing with the reactions of organoborane. That is, whatever organoborane we have prepared it, wo organoborane ke reactions kya kya ho sakte hai, wo hum abhi dekhte hain. तो ये R3B जो है वो हमने ऑलरेडी सिंथेसाइज किया है. नाउ R3B को हम कन्वर्ट कर सकते हैं अल्कोहल्स में. दैट इज व्हाट वी हैव सीन इट ओवर हियर इन दिस रिएक्शन. और इसमें जो स्टीरियोकेमिस्ट्री है एंड रिजियोसेलेक्टिविटी है, दिस इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. स्टीरियोकेमिस्ट्री एज वेल एज रिजियोसेलेक्टिविटी इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट फॉर दिस ऑर्गेनोबोरेन कंपाउंड. फर्स्ट रिएक्शन वी हैव सीन इट अबाउट दी oxidation to alcohols. Okay, यहाँ पे जब हम oxidation to alcohols करते हैं, तो what we have seen it here is that the R group is transferred to oxygen of the peroxide linkage. R group जब यहाँ से इधर में transfer होता है, so that transfer occurs. First, it will be the preferences for this transfer will be like primary will be preferred over the secondary
than the tertiary carbon. The migration will be normally of the order here. Migration of R will be primary more than secondary more than tertiary. तो प्राइमरी ग्रुप रहेगा, अगर तीनों ग्रुप हमारे अलग अलग हुए तो प्राइमरी जो ग्रुप होगा वो पहले ट्रांसफर होगा, देन सेकेंडरी ग्रुप एंड देन द टर्शियरी ग्रुप विल बी ट्रांसफर. सो वी कैन स्टॉप एट पर्टिकुलर पोजीशन एंड गेट द अल्कोहल अकॉर्डिंगली. सो व्हाट वी हैव इज फर्स्ट थिंग इज दैट द माइग्रेशन ऑफ आर will be first primary more than secondary more than tertiary. Second thing is stereochemistry of the migrating group will be retained. That is whatever this R group, the carbon directly attached to boron, उसका जो भी stereochemistry होगा वो यहाँ oxygen पे जाने के बाद भी same रहेगा, उसमें inversion नहीं आता है. So that is the important thing that is present, and here it will be the oxymercuration and demercuration steps are syn additions. So syn stereo specificity, that is the characteristic that we have already seen it. This syn stereo specificity will be seen in this particular cases also when boron gets added to it. Enantioselectivity can be obtained by using enantioselectivity can be obtained by using plus or minus IPC2BH. That is जो pinene से alpha and alpha pinene से जो हमें organoborins मिलते हैं उससे हमारा ये plus or minus very easily we can have it. We can get the examples for this as if we have a Z alkene and we are reacting it with a minus IPC 2BH. We will get this particular adduct organoborane compound. This organoborane compound then when reacted with hydrogen peroxide in basic medium, it will be giving us the alcohols. So the stereochemistry of this OH is retained over here. It is not changed. So here we will get this R alcohol. We will get R alcohol in 10:1 ratio. That is 10 will be R isomer. and one will be the S isomer. So it will be almost 92% of the R alcohol will be there and 8% will be the S alcohol. Then if we take, instead of Z alkene, if we take E alkene and we react with same IPC2 in the first reaction, and in second reaction H2O2 in basic medium, that is this adduct will be formed, and then we are breaking the adduct. So we will get the alcohol as just the reverse of this. We will get as a major product, that is S alcohol, we will get it as a major product. And this also in 10:1. So enantioselectivity can be easily obtained by using IPC2BH. IPC2BH में alpha pinene से मिलता है और उसे use करके हम यहाँ पे enantioselectively hydration कर सकते हैं. So that is one of the advantages for this particular reaction जो organoborans में है. ऑर्गेनोबोरोनिक या बोरोनेटिंग एजेंट जो है वो हम एनेंशियो सेलेक्टिव ले सकते हैं IPC2BH जैसा, एंड वी कैन गेट द पर्टिकुलर कंपाउंड्स. देन वी हैव अनदर एग्जांपल ऑफ रिएक्शंस और कन्वर्जन इनटू अमीन्स. कन्वर्जन इनटू प्राइमरी अमीन्स. प्राइमरी अमीन्स हम यहां से बना सकते हैं. Like if we have say organoborane compound, we have it, and if we react it with say hydroxyl amine or chloramine or hydroxyl amine, if we are reacting it with, there will be loss of proton, and this nitrogen lone pair will be added to the boron empty orbital. So this particular group now can be transferred to nitrogen and X will be moving out. It will be minus X, and we will have R2B NHR. This can be further in similar steps can be converted to B NHR twice. If we add two more moles of hydroxylamine, then we can have it chloramine or hydroxylamine ka yahan pe कर सकते हैं. ये X will be here either chlorine or OH. Hydroxylamine होगा तो OH होगा, chloramine होगा तो Cl होगा. So we will get this tri-substituted compound. This can be further hydrolyzed to give us boric acid and the primary amine. We'll get the primary amine and boric acid. So यहाँ पे जो cleavage होगा with water, OH will be added to boron and H will be added to NHR. So that it will become RNH2 and boron will become BOH twice. So that way primary amines can be easily obtained from this organoborane compounds. Similarly, we can do carbonylation also. That is addition of carbon monoxide can be done. addition of carbon monoxide can be done over the organoborins. In that, we can have tertiary alcohols, if we have say R3B, that is trialkyl borane, and if we are reacting it in ethylene glycol at 100 to 125 degrees Celsius, addition of CO in ethylene glycol as a solvent at 100 to 125 degrees Celsius. And in second step, we are doing same hydrogen peroxide in basic medium. What we will get is R3COH. R3COH can be obtained, or tertiary alcohol can be obtained. These tertiary alcohols, like for example, we can have say CH3 twice B, if we have it. Or now say CH3CH2 twice B, if we are having, and we are adding carbon monoxide, where carbon is having a negative charge and oxygen will be having a positive charge. So what will happen is boron and the carbon charge, the lone pair of electrons, this will be added to the empty orbital of boron, and we will obtain an attachment. We have here as an adduct with oxygen having positive charge. So now what happens is this particular one of the ethyl group will be transferred to carbon, and lone pair of electrons will be transferred to oxygen. What will happen is we will get this methyl groups over here, and here we will have carbon with a CH2 CH3 double bond oxygen. Now, again, this can be reacted with ethylene glycol. React with ethylene glycol. To obtain this ethyl group, we can represent it here, and yahan se hamara oxygen as a ethylene glycol will form a adduct, such that there will be a negative charge on the boron. So what will happen here is yahan se ek ethyl group wapas se ट्रांसफर होता है ये कार्बोनिल की तरफ में अलोंग विद इलेक्ट्रॉन, सो बोरॉन का चार्ज वापस से न्यूट्रलाइज हो जाता है, एंड वी विल हैव with CH2, CH3. And here we will have oxygen. So this way we will get this particular thing. Then again, यहाँ पे ये cyclization होगा and this lone pair of electrons will be donating its electrons to the boron's empty orbital. And we will have the cyclic attack will be formed. CH2, CH3, यहाँ पर हमारा कार्बन OH Now again there is a negative charge on this boron. So what happens is this particular ethyl group will also get transferred over here and ye yaha par aa jayega. This will move out. So we will have boron with the carbon having three different groups attached to it. Now, last step as H2O2 in basic medium will cleave this boron carbon bond such that H will be coming to. Boron part and OH will be going to the OH on both sides will be coming of H2O2. So we will have the other plus we will have over here as carbon with OH. So tertiary alcohol can be obtained. In this way, we can obtain tertiary alcohols very easily from the organoborane if we are adding carbon monoxide. What we have to remember here is that there is a extension of one carbon over here. Hamara ethyl group se boron ko attached, so do carbons se. Now we have got one this carbon coming from carbon monoxide. Oxygen hamara carbon monoxide wala nahi hai, lekin ye carbon hamara carbon monoxide se aaya hua hai. So that we have to remember over here. Then second reaction for this that is carbonylations mein agar hamara ye primary alcohol humne banaya secondary alcohol or the secondary alcohols and ketones also we can obtain it. Ketones and secondary alcohols can be obtained. Here, what we can have is this adduct that we had obtained it. So, yahan pe hamara ye jo adduct tha, this particular adduct. This adduct we are using it over here. Secondary alcohols and ketones banane mein bhi hum ye adduct ko use kar sakte hain. This particular compound we can use it. We will represent this ethylene glycol with just OH. CH2, CH3 yahan pe attached hai. So we have say OH over here. Aur yahan pe hamara ek CH2, CH3 attached hai. We have a carbon with OH and two ethyl groups attached to it. तो अगर इस पोजीशन पर हम इससे H2O2 इन प्रेजेंस ऑफ हाइड्रोक्साइड इफ यू डू इट एंड देन देयर विल बी अ क्लीवेज ऑफ दिस OH OH दोनों साइड में आ जाएंगे एंड वी विल हैव हियर एज कार्बन OH. So what we will get is, if our OH yahan pe milega, because one OH is already there and another OH is getting added. So it is a geminal diols are there. These geminal diols are little bit unstable, and so they gets converted into ketones. So we'll have this 3-pentanone can be easily obtained from here. Similarly, if we are doing it instead of H2O2, if we are adding only OH minus ions, if we are adding only OH minus ions, that is water addition. So water addition hoga to hydrogen is taraf mein aayega, OH boron ki taraf mein jayega. So in that case, what we will have is, we will have OH, and here we will have a H. So we will have a secondary alcohol. So water addition agar hum karenge yahan pe secondary adduct mein, to hume secondary alcohol milega. Agar hum uska hydrogen peroxide ke sath react karenge, to hume ketone milega. This can be obtained from hexyl borane normally. Hexyl borane se hume ye easily milta hai. Like for example, if we have mixed ketone, can be easily obtained. Hexyl borane is hexyl BH2. We can add a alkene 1 and alkene 2. That is, these are represented as R and R dash. And what we have, the adduct we will get is hexyl boron with R and R dash. Both added over here. Isme phir hum first reaction mein CO and H2O, and in second reaction we can have H2O2 in basic medium. So what we will have is, we will get RCO R dash as the final product. Example can be if we have a hexyl borane yahan pe do alkenes hain hamare paas, ek ye alkene jo cyclic ring ka part hai aur dusra alkene jo acyclic hai, dono hi borane ke sath react karenge. Yahan pe hamara R and R dash both are part of same group. Here across this carbon-carbon double bond, hydrogen यहाँ add होगा और boron इधर add होगा, दोनों same side से add हो रहे हैं. Then we have a hexyl over here. Now if we react this with CO, H2O in the first instance, and then H2O2 OH minus ions, we will get the product as this. So this simple things can be easily obtained. Yahan pe chain elongation hua hai. Number of carbons idhar mein 6, 7 and 8 the. Yahan pe we have 9 carbon atoms, because one carbon from carbonyl group has been added over here. So one carbon is added, plus we get from dialkene, we can get the ketones very easily. Then we can prepare aldehydes. By carrying out carbonylation in presence of a reducing agent, such as lithium aluminium or lithium trimethoxy aluminium hydride. If we have say जब एक ही ग्रुप यहाँ पे ट्रांसफर हुआ है विद दैट अदर वी आर टेकिंग इट और वी कैन हैव इट आर इफ वी आर एडिंग सीओ This R group transferred over here. We will get this particular adduct. Now, ये adduct बनने के बाद में दूसरा migration हम नहीं करवाते हैं और इसमें अगर हम lithium trimethoxy aluminium hydride अगर हम add करते हैं lithium trimethoxy aluminium hydride. So this hydride will be added across that and we will get yahan pe ye carbonyl jo carbon tha carbonyl carbon that will get added with one hydrogen. R group will remain as such and we will have oxygen then aluminium and OME flux. This adduct is treated with H2O2 in presence of hydroxide ions. We will get the RCHO group. RCHO can be easily obtained from this particular reaction. So aldehydes can be easily prepared by this. यहाँ पे एक ही ग्रुप ट्रांसफर हुआ है दो ग्रुप अगर ट्रांसफर हो जाते हैं तो we will get the alcohol, that is secondary alcohols or ketones. अगर एक ही ग्रुप ट्रांसफर होता है तो we will get this particular aldehydes can be obtained. Then we have addition of cyanide or we call it as cyanidation. That is addition of CN group. Nitrile can be added, which is isoelectric to carbon monoxide. Same number of electrons are present in both cyanide ion as well as carbon monoxide. So R3B, when reacted with CN minus, it will be forming an adduct similar to that of carbon monoxide. Now, if we add an anhydride, trifluoroacetic anhydride, if we add it, then we will get the adduct as नाइट्रोजन पे ट्राइफ्लोरो एसिटेट ऐड होता है विल गेट अ पॉजिटिव चार्ज ओवर नाइट्रोजन एंड नेगेटिव चार्ज इज ऑलरेडी देयर ऑन द बोरॉन. ये हम इसलिए कर रहे हैं कि इलेक्ट्रोफिलिसिटी नाइट्रोजन का हम बढ़ा सकें. इलेक्ट्रोफिलिसिटी नाइट्रोजन का बढ़ेगा तो ही हमारा ये आर ग्रुप जो है दिस आर ग्रुप विल गेट माइग्रेटेड ओवर द कार्बन. R group will get migrated to the carbon. So what we will get over here is we will have a R and two R's will be remaining with boron. We will have a carbon which is now having one R and a double bonded to nitrogen which is still bonded with trifluoroacetate. Now what happens here, there is a R group, another R group gets transferred to this carbon and ये nitrogen के electrons यहाँ relay होते हैं and oxygen attached in boron. So it will be forming 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5 membered ring. Processing boron, oxygen, carbon double bonded with nitrogen, then a carbon attached to boron, and now here we have two R groups added. Now in this case, if we add H2O2 in basic medium, what we will get is there will be cleavage of this bond and this bond will get cleaved. We'll get this bond and this bond will be cleaved, and so we will have ROR will be obtained. That is, ketones can be obtained in this case. We'll get the ketones over here. अगर थर्ड ग्रुप भी हम माइग्रेट करने देते हैं तो फिर हमें टर्शियरी अल्कोहल मिले. यहाँ पे हमारा आर एक और एक आर ग्रुप रह गया है. अगर इसे भी हम माइग्रेट करने देते हैं, अलाउ इट टू माइग्रेट इट एंड देन ऐड H2O2, देन वी विल गेट द टर्शियरी अल्कोहल्स, देन वी विल गेट द टर्शियरी अल्कोहल्स. दिस मेथड इज सुपीरियर टू कार्बोनिलेशन इफ लोअर टेम्परेचर्स आर नीडेड. This requires lower temperatures. Carbonylation में हमें temperatures around 100 to 125 degree Celsius लग रहे थे. यहाँ पे हमारा वो temperatures नहीं लगते हैं. So that is one advantage with this particular method.